Adventure 7, Siege of Darkness. Lul's forces have found Mithril Hall. You must hold out against their attack. The objective is to close the Underdark fissures and defeat all the monsters. So, just a quick setup, or I guess explanation of the setup, is that for this adventure, it's actually a predetermined dungeon, and in the rulebook, there's actually a way how to do it. So this is how it ended up for me when I set it up, because it's random, because you just draw them from the, you draw the tiles from the a shuffled tile stack, and then set up the fissures accordingly. And as you can see, well, I guess you can kind of see, there's a fissure 1 through 5 here, 6 through 10 here, 11 through 15 here, and all the way over here is 16 to 20. And that corresponds to a die roll that I have to do at, when is it, at the beginning of each hero's exploration phase. I'll have to roll a die, and if the fissure is not closed, then a monster is going to spawn there. And then the way to close fissures is, each fissure has 2 hit points because there's 2 players in the game. The way you are able to close the fissures is a hero must be on the tile edge next to the fissure tile, and the hero can deal a damage to the fissure instead of moving. So I have to give up my move action. So since you're able to move twice on your turn, as 2 separate actions, you can deal 2 damage to it. So that's something to keep in mind. The heroes I have are Regis and, what is it, Buerenor? So I randomly shuffled and got them. Regis has spider masks, so he's able to end the immobilized condition when he is immobilized. And then Buerenor has Bracers of Blinding Strike. After he uses an at-will attack power against an adjacent monster, he's able to use an at-will attack power against an adjacent monster. This ability can only be used once per hero phase. So he's actually able to attack twice, which is pretty good. And there's no flipping that or discarding it, so it's an item that just lets him use another at-will power. I guess it's not really considered another action. But anyway, what's going to happen is, at some point, after I close the second fissure, the boss of the level is going to spawn. And then the way I win is to close all the fissures and kill the boss. So, when I start the adventure, Dwarven scouts have reported that vile servants of the Drow are gathering in tunnels near Mithril Hall and will soon launch an assault on the stronghold. You and your companions have located a section of the Underdark that the Drow forces must travel through to reach Mithril Hall. If you can collapse those tunnels, you will thwart the Drow attack. Alright, so I guess I should probably have Buerenor start, since he has more HP, and if he gets hit, then, well, I don't know. Maybe I should have Regis, because then Buerenor could come attack. So Regis is here. I've got those two that are kind of split, but then I have this area which is all pooled together. And if I think about it ahead of time, the lady is going to spawn at the place with the fissure with the most HP remaining. So if I go close these two, then she's going to spawn here with potentially a ton of monsters already over here. So I don't know if I want to do that or if I should split up first. Let's split up first. So I'll have Regis go, you can go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4. So Regis can move all the way here. He's just going to double move for his turn. And I guess I didn't realize it, that I'm never going to be drawing monster cards in this, since I'm never exploring new places. But I guess what's going to happen is I will draw encounter cards no matter what, even though it's, because I guess the way it works is what it says is if you didn't place a tile during your exploration phase. So I think they have that built in where it's going to be that I have to draw an, what is it? Encounter card, and then eventually there's part of the story I'll let you know when we get there where I won't have to draw them anymore. But anyway,
I did my hero phase for Regis, and then during the exploration phase, I'm going to roll the die, and I got a 4, so that's where the monsters start coming in. It's going to be a goblin archer, and he's going to spawn near the 4. Is that where you... Yeah, it just says place it on the cabin tile, so I assume it's going to spawn here like normal. So that was his exploration, and now the villain phase. The encounter card is... Ooh, that's rough. It's going to be the poison arrow trap. Place the poison arrow trap marker on the hero's tile. If that tile already has a marker, discard it. So poison arrow trap's going to go here. Trigger the trap during your villain phase. Each hero within one tile is poisoned. So it is the villain phase. It's going to activate because that's the only thing out there. So since it's only him, because what's his name? Buernor is within 2. Only Regis gets poisoned, which I guess it could have been a lot worse, because in the other games the traps would do like 1, 2, or 3 damage. So he gets poisoned. Actually, the way it works is the monster is supposed to activate. I put it on the wrong side. So the monster goes first. So Goblin Archer is within 2. 1, 2, 3. Nope. So he moves one tile towards the hero with the fewest hit points, which is going to be Regis, but it doesn't matter, it's just one. So now it is going to be, well, it would have been the Goblin Archer, then the Poison Trap, and now the turn's over. So it's Buernor's turn, and he has a speed of 5, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, won't get him there. His notched axe only lets him attack adjacent monsters. I guess I should probably, I'll put his, the Buernor stance. I can put it at the beginning of my hero phase. I can use up the start of your hero phase, place the stance token on this card. While your stance token is on this card, your hero gets a +2 bonus speed. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. He wouldn't have been able to double move there anyway, so I will have to place it there. So I place the stance on it so he can double move. While your stance token is on this card, your hero has a +2 bonus to speed. So his speed is a 7 now, so we'll go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4. And he will end his hero phase there. So exploration phase, 11. Ooh, that spawns right next to him, which is... not good, I guess. Spider Swarm. So the Spider Swarm's gonna spawn there. And then at the beginning of the villain phase is the encounter. Oh boy, it's another trap. Volcanic Fault. Place the Volcanic Fault on the hero's tile. So I'll place the fault there. This trap tile counts as a volcanic vent tile. Trigger during the trap phase. Each hero within one tile of a volcanic vent takes 1 damage. Ooh, that's all volcanic vents over here. So, first it's going to be the Spider Swarm that activates. So it is, if the Spider Swarm is on a tile with a poisoned hero, nope. If it's within one tile of a hero, it moves to the closest hero tile and attacks each hero on that tile with 1,000,000 venomous fangs. So it's not going to move, but it's still going to attack him. A 12 and a 7 is a 19. That is enough to poison him. And then the volcanic vent's going to activate. And each hero within one tile of a volcanic vent takes a damage. So both of them are taking a damage. From that, oh, this is really not good, because I just wanted, if the Spider Swarm wasn't there, then he could just sit there, but, all right. Well, since that's it for him, it's going to be Regis's turn. Regis takes a damage from the poison. He is going to not move twice to get to close the fissure. So let's get that fissure closed. That's a fourth of the thing completed. After he doesn't move, it's the exploration phase, so time for a monster. Comes out at 6. So the monster is going to be the Drow Duelist. He's going to spawn over here because 6 is there. And once this is closed, no monsters can spawn there when I roll it on the die. So, alright, Goblin Archer is not within 2, so he just moves 1. Poison Arrow Trap. Each hero within 1 tile of this trap's tile is poisoned, so he stays poisoned. Oh, actually, he would have rolled during his hero phase to get unpoisoned, but he's just going to get poisoned again because he's not moving. And then the Drow Duelist moves 1 tile. So that's how that ends. It's going to be Buernor's turn. So Buernor takes a damage from being poisoned. He is not adjacent, so this is really bad. Can't really do anything because the Spire Swarm is just going to give him an automatic damage. So he's just not going to move and close the fissure because that's probably the best thing to do right now. And then he would roll to see if he gets rid of the poison. He did not. He got a 1. And I'm not going to waste the utility power to reroll that. So he didn't do that. It is now going to be roll for the monsters. See what spawns. A 1. That's not good. Stalagmite. Do not place a monster. So nothing goes there. That was lucky on my part. Then it's going to be an encounter. Did I not draw an encounter for Regis? I think I did not do that, because that was the first, that was the second, then it would have been him. So let's resolve Regis's encounter really quick. It's Mark of the Wolf, so he takes a damage and he gets the Mark of the Wolf. So that was easy to resolve. So now his encounter, Buernor, is Mark of the Wolf. So he takes a damage, and each hero with 1 curse takes 1 damage, so actually Regis would have taken, will take a damage now. So that is the encounter for the turn, and then now it is going to be the villains. So first thing is Spider Swarm will automatically damage Buernor 1, and then Volcanic Vent will go off and damage both of them 1. So I need to either get rid of the Volcanic Vent or start moving fast. And I don't think he can get out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. I guess he could get out of the way of the Volcanic Vent, so. But then he's right near the archer and stuff. And then that was the Volcanic Fault activating, so now it is back to Regis. Regis is poisoned, so he takes a damage. He only has 2 hit points left, so this is not good. He could take a damage at the end of his hero phase to get rid of Mark of the Wolf, which... Alright, so the first thing... What are we going to do? I think we're going to have to do this Ruby Pendant. So what we're going to do is use his rogue ability Tumble. Use at the start of any phase, move your hero any square within 1 tile. So he will move all the way over here, because that's 1 tile. And then he is going to move. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. He can only go 6. Ah, that hurts. Because Volcanic Vent's going to hit him if he doesn't. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then he's going to, well, actually, for the Goblin Archer, if he's adjacent, he will cower. So let's move him 6, so that way the Archer doesn't shoot him. Well, actually, it doesn't matter. Well, actually, maybe, because I could attack the Drow Duelist with the Ruby Pendant, and then on a hit, move the monster 1 tile, then deal 1 damage to 1 monster on the tile. So I could probably kill him. Actually, I should probably do that with the archer, because the archer has lower armor. That might be the better way to do this. Yeah, let's attack the Goblin Archer with Ruby Pendant. That is a 6. I am glad I chose that, because the 6 plus the ruby pendant, 6 is 12, which is exactly enough to hit the goblin archer to kill it. Well, it's not going to kill it, actually. I am going... who do I? Yeah, maybe I want to kill it. Well, the Drow Duelist attacks twice. This is tough. Yeah, let's kill the Drow Duelist, because I think that is probably worse for me, because he has a plus 9. So what happens is Ruby Pendant will move this guy here, and then I do 1 damage to someone on this tile, so I'll damage him to kill him. Get a treasure card, bolster, choose one hero. That hero either regains 1 hit point or ends 1 condition. We're going to regain a hit point, and then at the end of that hero phase, he's going to roll to see if he can get rid of poisoned, and he does. And then now is the question, do I want to get rid of Mark of the Wolf? I think I need to, because it's a pain. So he'll take a damage to get rid of the curse. Might end up killing him, but it's better than him dying and still having it. So that's the end of his hero phase. We will roll for the monsters from the fissures. 16. That one is closed, so no monster spawns. Now an encounter card. Attack each hero on your hero's tile. Great. That is going to miss him, and a miss does 1 damage, so he is probably going to die soon. And I completely screwed up, because what's-her-name was supposed to spawn. Actually, that was on his turn when he did that. Yikes. Alright, so... I guess I'm going to try to fix this as best as I can without going back. So after the second fissure is closed, you breathe a sigh of relief as another passage collapses, but then a chilling voice speaks from the darkness. Destroy the outcast and his friends, and the Spider Queen will celebrate this day. The matron mother of House Baron Beniri, I don't know, has arrived. So what I do is I will take... what's her name? Vanel Benir, and place her on the tile next to the fissure with the most, so she goes there. And then for the rest of the adventure, do not draw an encounter card during the villain phase unless specified by her tactics. So here's where I'm going to try to fix things as best as I can. So this acid spray would not have gone off. I'm going to put it back on top of the deck and give Regis back a hit point, because she would have already been out, and because what happened was he closed the fissure, she would have spawned, and then the rats attacked him, and then it went to him who did all his stuff, so she would have had 1 activation. So let's activate her really quick and see what happens. Adjacent, nope, is within 1 tile of a hero. She attacks each hero. Nope, that wouldn't have been there. So otherwise, she channels Lulz Fury. The active hero must draw the top encounter card of the deck. So the way this would have worked was when she activated, the active hero was him. So he would have to take the acid spray. So trying to resolve this. 6 and 6 is 12. It's a miss, so he takes a damage. So I think we are pretty much back to what would have happened. So she's just going to sit here right now and make encounter cards go off. But what would have happened was she activated, the spiders activate to poison or to do the damage. Then Regis activates, comes over here, does his stuff. And then I do not draw an encounter card. I think that's where I stopped, was the encounter card, because he has no poison or curse anymore. So he does not draw an encounter card during the villain phase. Now the villains activate, and she's going to activate first. So she's going to draw, or I guess Regis draws the top one. Oh boy. Wow, setting it up, or getting things fixed, kind of hurt me. Shock trap. Trigger the trap during your villain phase. Attack each hero on this trap's tile. 3 damage, and if it's a miss, it's 1 damage. So, this is horrible. for Regis. So how can we do this? Well, if, I guess the way it's supposed to go is she did her thing, so Goblin Archer's within one. He's going to attack Regis. 9 and 7 is 16. That's a hit, so it kills him. So he's dead. And then Poison Arrow Trap. Nobody's within one, so it's done. Shock Trap. Attack each hero on this tile. He's already dead, so it doesn't attack him. And I think that is going to be it for his turn. So back to Buerenor. He takes a damage from the poison. And I've been screwing up. I haven't been using their abilities. The end of your hero phase, you can take a damage to deal a damage. That wouldn't have been helpful. Regis could have... well, actually, his is worthless here. So my random shuffling Regis is kind of worthless because it's during the villain phase when you would get to use his ability, and the monsters come out in the exploration for this one. So anyway, it is Buerenor's turn. And what do we want him to do? You go one. Now you can't even walk out of here. I guess we'll just move him here, because if you can see, it blocks it. So the monster is blocking him in. So he's going to use his notched axe. Once during each of your turn, your hero phase, if this attack misses, you could attack a different monster, but there's not, so... 19 is a hit, so he's going to kill the spider swarm. So they're gone. He gets a treasure. Scrimshaw Charm lets him re-roll at any point. So he moved, he attacked, and that's it. So let's roll for poison. That hurts. I'm going to use the charm to re-roll because the poison's really hurting. Alright, so poison's gone. Alright, and then now it is going to be the exploration, so roll for that. 13, that's close, so no monster. Then Yvonne's going to activate, not adjacent, not within one, so she makes him draw an encounter card. It's Mark of the Wolf. Wow. Your hero's curse places... Each hero with at least one curse takes one damage. At the end, your hero can take one damage to discard. So I'm assuming these will stay on. Like, they don't stack, as in they don't make him take two damage whenever it comes out. It says if he has at least one curse, he takes a damage. So when this comes out, he has two now, so he takes one damage. But it's going to cost me two hit points to get rid of both of them, so that's a bad curse. And I can't prevent it right now, I only have two or four experience. So, where is it? She activated. Now it's him, so the only thing is the volcanic vent, which gives him a damage. He's going to have to get out of there soon. So it's now Regis's turn, so he has to spend a healing surge to come back with 4 HP, which is really bad. And he needs to get off of this tile. It's not good for him. I feel like he should just go in and try to kill her real quick, but that might not be very smart. He could Ruby Pendant, which would actually that'd be pretty good, because then I could move this over here and deal her a damage. So I think I'm going to do that, Ruby Pendant, and that works. So this will move here and deal her a damage. Oh, but then I didn't think about the encounter cards, but... Whatever, it's buying me time right now. And then he'll move away from there, so 1, 2, so he's not on the shock trap tile. And then it's going to be the exploration phase. So roll this. A 2. So a new monster comes out. Goblin Cutter. He's going to spawn over here. And then villain phase is activating her. No monster, or no heroes near her. So encounter card, attack your hero. This could end him. 15, that's going to do 2 damage. That hurts. I can't stop it. So he's almost dead again. And Buenor is pretty much going to die soon, maybe? Alright, so she activated. Goblin Archer is 1, 2, 3 away, so he moves 1. And then Poison Arrow. No one near it. Shock Trap, no one on it. Goblin Cutter. Within 1 tile of a hero, otherwise move him 1. So he moves 1 as well. Alright, so that's it for Regis's turn. It is now Buenor, and he is not in a good place right now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So let's move him there. Because I can't risk trying to disarm that trap, and if it fails, then he's taking the damage next turn. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I'm going to move him over here because I can't afford the goblin to shoot him because it's going to kill him if it does. Let's just move him here. If I did this right or not, we'll see. Alright, so roll for the monster summon. 12 is a fail. It's closed. Then it's going to be the Yvonne or Vanel activating, so he has to draw. Each hero on a volcanic vent takes 2 damage. They are not on it, so that's good. And then volcanic fault activates, and this portion of the board is what would take 1 damage, but they're away from that, so they're good. So his turn is done. It is Regis now. If I move in and stay adjacent to him and move the Goblin Cutter over, then that could work. Or I guess I could just kill the Goblin Cutter. I think that might be the better way to go. But then she'll attack him. I guess he'll do that. 1, 2. And then he's going to Ruby Pendant. He got a 6. So 6 and 6 is a success. So I am moving the Goblin Cutter over here, and then I'm going to deal a damage to the Goblin Cutter to kill it. So that way I get experience and a treasure. Tunnel map. Use during your exploration. Place the top tile of the dungeon. Oh, this is worthless. Alright. So it is now roll for the spawn a monster. 19. This is closed off. She's going to make him activate an encounter. Each hero on a volcanic vent takes 2 damage, so nope. Then, who is it? The Goblin Archer is cowering in fear. Right? Yes, so he does nothing, and then these two go off, and nothing happens. So is Buenor just going to like sit there? He can't really do much. I guess he could move in here and attack, because it's adjacent. Oh, actually, I did that wrong. The volcanic vent thing did not go off. Since he is within 1 of her, she actually does a different tactic. So I should back up and have her do her thing, which is within 1 tile, she attacks each hero on the closest hero tile with a blast of fire. This could actually change it a lot. 9 and 8 is 17, so it succeeds, kills Regis, and then it says, and move the hero 1 tile in any direction. I'm going to say thematically he can't get through there. Honestly, I would want to put him over there. With the game's rules, I could if I wanted to, but I feel like this goblin dude is blocking the path, so he would be pushed 1 that way. which is bad for me because then the Goblin Archer activates and attacks him. Is that a 9 and 7, 16? So it's a hit, and he dies. Or he's already dead, so he wouldn't be hit by the Goblin Archer. The Goblin Archer actually shoots Buernor. 6 and 7 is 13. It's a miss, but it still does a damage. So Buernor's dead. So I think I failed this one. And then at the beginning of Buernor's turn, he's going to come back with 5 HP. Not that it matters. I'll just hurry up and do this. He can only go 1, 2, 3, attack that thing. Ooh, he actually got a 20 on it, but that doesn't matter because I'm not going to level him up. I'm just going to kill this thing, get a treasure. Flask of oil is nothing that can help, and he's done because he can't do anything else. So, she's going to, her first roll for monster, 8, so a monster does spawn, Goblin Cutter, then she activates, so she attacks him, that's going to hit him for 2, and move him back 1, and then the Goblin, actually, I'm going to have it move him in closer, because the Blast of Fire is very unlucky for him. Just for whatever reason, I've already lost. And then the Goblin Cutter activates. And he is going to attack. 5 and 7 is a miss. And then his turn's over. Regis starts. No healing surge, so I lost. So I will play this again and redo the map and stuff and see what happens. So Buernor's dead. Feral Troll now passes, and then it is Regis's turn. So he's poisoned, he takes a damage. Ugh, I've lost, but I can at least try to close that, right? So, I am going to not move to close it, and then I'm going to use I can use Flask of Oil. So choose one tile away from you, attack each monster on that tile. So I can attack everything, so let's start with the Drake. 17, it kills the Drake. Get a treasure. Ooh, Potion of Healing, that's going to be useful. Then attack the Troll. 17 is a hit, so it takes a damage. And then attack the Lady. 14 and 4 is 18. That's enough to hit her, so she takes a damage too. Alright, so all I gotta do is kill her now. So that was his attack, and he already did his not moving, so he's done. Or he can use his Potion of Healing, that's what he wants to do. So he regains 2 hit points. Now he's done, so roll to spawn. Nothing can spawn, so no more spawning. That's good. And then her activation. She's within one tile, so she's going to fire blast him. Miss does 1 damage. And he was supposed to roll for his poison, which stays on him. Blah. And I don't know if I mentioned if I took the poison off or not. I feel like I didn't. So I'm going to take 1 off. If I didn't, whatever. So, she went. Now it's the Feral Troll. Within 1 tile, attack it. So he's moving and attacking Regis. It could actually be the end of the game now. Nope, it misses. So the miss does nothing, and the card moves. So it is Buernor coming back to life with 5. And then he stands up. And he should probably... how can I do this? The notched axe. Actually, Actually, I could have used that one treasure he had. That was the mummy. But anyway, notched axe to attack the lady. Wow, one is a miss, but I'm going to use my charm to reroll. Wow, a 4 and a 7 is a miss. I'm going to use my lucky hit utility power. And oh, there we go. So that's a hit. And then I'm going to use a power strike to do 2 damage to her total. She close to dying. Yikes, that stupid troll is in my way, and I could end it if he wasn't. Ah! Alright, so Buernor is going to take a damage to give her a damage at the end of his hero phase. And I think that's all he can do, because there's no other adjacents to attack. Or no, that was last game. So alright, he's done. Can't spawn monsters. What's the next thing? She activates. She's adjacent, so she's going to use her dagger. That hits him for 1, but I'm going to use the Brooch of Shielding to reduce that by 1. He's poisoned. And then she moves 1 tile. So move her there, I guess. Alright, it was Buernor who did that, so Water Elemental within 1 tile, he is. Surging Wave. Does he move in or not? It moves to the closest hero tile. Yeah, so he's here, and Surging Wave. That does 1 damage to Buernor. Alright, 7. Actually, no. Oh, 17, yeah, definitely. And then after the Water Elemental is the Feral Troll, and he, this isn't good. He's going to attack with the Nasty Claw. So this could be the game-ending strike. Yep, it kills Regis. So Regis is dead. Feral Troll passes, and then end of his turn. So Regis' turn, no healing surge, so it's over. And I think at this point, I've played it twice. I'm going to get rid of Regis because he's too much of a liability now. So he's going to go away and I'll pick someone else to replace him, unfortunately. But yeah, I don't want to keep playing this like 20 times. So that's what I'm going to do, and I'll have that up in a little bit. Or actually, it'll be in the same video, so. Alright, so I'm back with my 3rd attempt. And right now, Vanel just spawned. There was a Feral Troll on the board, and I've got Wolfgar and Buernor this time. I got rid of Regis. So what just happened was the second fissure got closed after he did nothing, and when he ended his hero phase, he deals 1 damage to him by taking a damage. That's at the end of the hero phase. So he gets the Scrimshaw Charm. Your Duelist is dead. Then there is a roll for the spawn. 5, which is up here. So the monster is going to be the Drow Wizard. I thought I was doing well at first, but I guess not. So there's no encounter card, but then Yavel activates and says, Yavel channels Lost Fury, and they draw an encounter card. So he got Mark of the Wolf, so Buernor takes a damage. And let's see, it is now Wolfgar's turn. Oh, actually, no, sorry. She activated, then the Feral Troll activates. He regains all his hit points and moves 1 tile closer to the hero with the fewest, so it doesn't matter, it's just going to go there. He had no damage. Then Drow Wizard teleports to the tile with the most heroes, then attacks each hero with a blast of fire. They're on 2 separate ones, so I'll just put him here. And attack. 13 and 8, it's a hit, so 2 damage to Wolfgar. Alright, so it is Wolfgar's turn. And how do I want to do this? You can move 7. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Will not get him there. Does he want to kill the drow wizard? He could attempt to rampage the feral troll. That might be the best option, is getting rid of that feral troll. Or he could bear hug it and deal 3 damage, but then it wouldn't kill it. It would just... that's tough. I think what I'm going to do is attack the drow wizard with... Oh, actually... +4 bonus. Yeah, that's not going to help. Yeah, I'll attack the drow wizard with rampage. So if it's +5 attack and then damage is 1, and it says I can attack an adjacent monster after I attack an adjacent monster. So 2 attacks. 10 and 5 is 15. Drow wizard has a 16, so it misses. Ooh, that's a miss. Boyernor is going to use his item to let him reroll that, to let Wolfgar reroll it. And that hits, so... actually, he doesn't get the bonus on the damage. That was dumb of me. So it only did 1 damage to the drow wizard. And then he's going to move 7. So let's go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And then we will roll for spawning. 13 is down here. So draw a monster. Water elemental. Actually, the feral troll should have been passed. So water elemental down here. Then an encounter card because of her. Each hero on a volcanic vent takes 2 damage. Neither of them are. So she activated. Now the drow wizard. I guess he'll just keep teleporting after him and attack. So 2 damage. And then the water elemental is not within a tile, so he just moves 1 forward. Alright. Oh, wait a second. The drow wizard did not do that because I got this messed up. Give 2 back to Wolfgar. Water elemental is supposed to go over here. I got him confused. They are on the wrong side. So it's actually supposed to be the spider swarm that activates after the lady. So spider swarm, volcanic fault, nobody takes damage. Feral troll. He moves 1 to the hero with the lowest, which is Wolfgar, so move him 1 there. And then he passes, and then the water elemental will move in. Alright, so that's it for Wolfgar. Now it's Boyernor, and he's kind of far away. I could give him the hurry up thing, which would let him 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7... 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm just going to keep his shield and move him 5 and use the notched axe to attack the drow wizard. And it missed. And I don't have anything to let him reroll. Crap. Oh, actually, I do. I never flipped that card over. Lucky hit I can use. I knew I had one. I just didn't flip it over from last game. 8 and 7 is 15. Drow wizard is 16, so it misses. Great. Well, I guess at the end of my turn I can take a damage to deal a damage to kill him. Can't forget that, right? So drow wizard dies. Get a treasure. Brooch of shielding, that'll help. Then roll for spawning. 9. That one is closed. It's all the way over there. Then her is an encounter card. Poison arrow trap. Ooh. It would be put over there. I think I'll let this one go in case there's a worse thing. So it's going to be put there. And where do I set it? Over here. Alright, so she activated. Now the feral troll will move 1 closer. So great. And then pass. And then the poison arrow trap poisons Buernor. So that's it for his turn. It is now Wolfgar's turn, who has 5 HP. I can try to attack everything, or I could sneak and go 1, 2, 3. Because he has Flask of Oil, he can attack each monster on that tile, but I think, yeah, everything except the Spider Swarm has more than one. So, how should I do this? I think I'm just going to Flask of Oil. So, it's a plus 4 to attack each hero on this, or each monster on that tile. So let's start with the Spider Swarm. 14, it kills it.
Yay.
And he got Wand of Acid Arrows, which I guess I'll probably use another time. And then he's going to attack the Water Elemental. And that 9 and, what did I say, 4 is 13. That's enough to hit the Water Elemental, so that takes a damage. And then attack the Feral Troll. 11 and 4 is enough to do a damage to it. So that takes a damage. And the only problem is, if I move away from the Feral Troll, it's going to heal. So I might want to just stand there, right? I will use my healing herbs first to give him 2 HP back, and then I will move there to be adjacent to both of them. Ooh, the only problem is she's going to attack him, and then the troll heals, so I guess I shouldn't really do that, right? He's got 7, so let's go 1, 2, 3. And my armor's down there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I'll move him up here. And that way the Feral Troll will heal, but whatever. So, encounter, or spawn. 18 is a failed spawn. Mark of the Loth. So, each of them are taking a damage. Then it's going to be Volcanic Fault, nothing. Water Elemental, one tile. And then Feral Troll moves one tile after he heals. And he passes over. Alright, so Buernor, he takes a damage from being poisoned. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Gets him there. Maybe I don't want to do that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, I think he's going to do this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Double move. And he has his defense up. And he's going to end his hero phase, take a damage himself to give her a damage. And then roll for poison. He got a 14, so he's not poisoned. And then it's going to be spawning. 15, which is next to him, great. It's another water elemental, so two are going to be activating. So she's going to do her encounter card. Rock slide, each hero on your tile moves one tile in the direction of the tile's arrow, then each hero on a new tile takes one damage. So he's going to be pushed over here. Do I want to let that happen? I don't think I do, because he needs to be there to close that fissure, kind of. So I'm going to negate this with my 5 experience. So that was her. Oh no, hold on. Let's go back. I realize she doesn't do that encounter card because she's next to him, so she activates her ability of if she's adjacent, she attacks with a poison dagger. And then moves one tile in any direction. So she got a 20, so it hits him, and he's poisoned. And then she'll move. Alright. So now it is... Wait, Buernor, her poison arrow trap, nobody. Oh, within one tile. Crap. So he does get poisoned. Wolfgar does. He's within one. Feral Troll. Move in and attack. Right? He's within one tile. Yep. Four. Alright, so the Feral Troll hit for three damage. And move the hero two tiles. This works out in my favor. One, two. Alright, I'll put it there. Just so it's not completely in my favor. I still have to waste some time, but whatever. I'm doing that because it's my third time. And I guess if I played it correct, but thematically, he would be thrown that way. But the troll has a mean right hook, and it sent him that way. So, anyway, Feral Troll is passed over. So now the water elementals activate. So this one first is going to slam, and it hits for two. Oh, actually, I have Brooch of Shielding, which will reduce that by one. So that saves him for a bit. And then the other water elemental activates, and he moves one towards the closest hero. One, two, three. One, two. So this way. Ah. Alright, so that's it for the monsters. It is now Buernor's turn. He takes a damage from the poison, which is not good. And what is he gonna do? He could try to kill that thing, or he could just do nothing and close the fissure, which I think is the best thing to do. And I think he'll spend his last HP to deal a damage to that water elemental, and it kills himself. Which is kind of good because it makes those guys move that way, I guess. Alright, so after that is summoning. There's no six because it's closed. Then she makes an encounter happen, which is now the rock slide, which is for him, but he's not there, so nothing happens. And then for Buernor, poison arrow trap goes off, nothing. Wait, no, I caught my mistake. She activates, then it's a volcanic vent, and then the water elementals, this one first. I'll move there, and then here, and then Feral Troll. He's already healed, but he'll move this way. And then he passes, and that's it for I'm really bad at keeping this straight. It was Buernor's turn. I'm so dumb. Put this back. I'm really sorry about this, guys. I don't know why I can't keep this straight. I think because the Feral Troll keeps hopping back and forth. So he was over here. So both water elementals will activate. So I don't think much really changes. Then the Feral Troll. Yeah, okay, so I think everything is right. Yeah. In the end, it didn't matter. I just wasted everybody's time. A minute or two. Alright, so that was Buernor. He's dead. So it comes over to Wolfgar. He takes a damage from the poison. Do I want to try to close it? Or do I want to try to kill that Feral Troll? Well, I can't close it completely, so I have to... I could try to do Wand of Acid Arrows. Yeah, I'll do that. Wand of Acid Arrows. Well, no, because it's just going to waste... Yeah, I guess. Well, he's within one tile, so he's not going to heal, right? If it's within one tile. Okay, good. So yeah, I'll do Wand of Acid Arrows. Yeah. Yeah, let's do that. Wand of Acid Arrows. 9 and 5 is 14, and it deals 2, but since Wolfgar has less than 4 HP, it deals an extra damage. So the Feral Troll just took 3 damage. And I lose that. And then for the last thing, he'll move here. I didn't think that through, but okay. And then roll for poison. It's gone. She's going to activate, or no, spawn first. 18 is a failed spawn. She makes an encounter happen. Attack each hero on your tiles. I will negate that with my experience. Then it's going to be the water elementals. Move and move. And then the feral troll will come in and swing. Let's hope he misses. He does not, so he kills Wolfgar. And it says remove the hero two tiles, so I assume that's still going to happen. So he gets thrown that way, unfortunately. So he passes over to Buernor, who is going to Healing Surge to come back. Stand back up, Buernor. All right. What's he gonna do? He's going to 1, 2, 3, and he's going to attack with Notched Axe. Ugh. 7 and 7 is 14. Oh, her armor is a 14. Awesome. So he can spend a power strike to do an extra damage to her. And I'm debating on if I should use his ability or not. That would put her down a lot more, but probably not good with a water elemental coming, and she's going to poison him again. Yeah, this is going to be interesting. I'm not going to do that, just to be safe. And then I will roll for the poison. He stays poisoned. And then, let's see, it's going to be spawn roll. Failed. She's going to attack him with a dagger. She hits him. He's already poisoned. She'll move one. Then it's going to be the water elementals. So it's within one. Moves to the tile and hits with a surging wave. 6 and 8 is 14. It's a miss. And then this guy's going to move over here because he's dead. And then the feral troll is going to heal, I believe. Yep. And then move one. Oh boy. How am I going to do this? So, it's going to healing surge. Wolfgar back to life. He's got 6 right now, so his ability doesn't kick off. He stands up. Now, do I want to try to do a bear hug on the lady? I think that's what I want to do. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. Do I want a bear hug or do I want a rampage? Because rampage could get rid of that water elemental, and them activating twice is not good. So I'm going to rampage, attack the water elemental. 10. Yep, that's enough to kill it. Get the treasure. Bolster. Choose one hero. That hero either regains one hit point or ends a condition. I'm going to end the poison on Buernor. And then he gets to finish his rampage on the lady. Ooh, critical, but I don't have enough experience. So it just does 1 damage to her. Alright, so spawn time. 7 is a failed spawn. She's adjacent, so she's going to use her dagger on him. And that's going to hit, so 1 and poisoned. She moves 1. Let's bring her towards the feral troll to make it harder. And then... was Wolfgar who did it, so the troll activates and he'll move here. and pass over. So now it is Blairnor's turn. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Or 7 could get him next to her, but I think he needs to kill this thing. So let's kill the water elemental with notched axe. 9 and 7 is enough to kill it. Deal 1 damage to 1 monster on your hero's tile. That is a waste of a treasure right there, if I've ever seen one. And now he has 5 movement. 5 would get him on the tile. Yeah, let's put him here. I think that's an okay plan. So, spawn roll. 4. Ah, crap, I knew it would happen. What? Oh, he already has a feral troll. Okay, good. That is the luckiest I've been. Stalagmite, do not place a monster. Oh, man, my heart just skipped a beat. I thought another was coming out. But he controls the feral troll right now, so... what's her name? Vanelle is going... She's not adjacent, but she's within 1, so she can blast a fire him. She got an 8, and an 8 is a 16. His defense is an 18, so he does not get hit. So she failed. And then the feral troll is within 1 tile. It moves adjacent and attacks. So just move there. 13 and 8 is 21, so 3 damage. Ooh. And move the hero 2 tiles. So if it was a mean right hook, he would hit the wall, so we'll go this way. So let's... Feral Troll moves over. Wolfgar's turn. He is going to take a damage from poison. He's at 4 hit points. He's going to go 1, 2, and attack the troll with a bear hug. And it hits, thank goodness. So the feral troll dies. And the treasure he gets is a cure potion. Your hero or an adjacent hero regains 1 hit point and ends 1 condition, so the poison's gone. Awesome, that was good. So that's the end of his turn. So spawn roll, failed. She is going to blast a fire him. She got a 14, so that's going to hit him for 2. And move the hero 1 tile. Oh, so he was actually supposed to be there because it only knocked him 1 away. So, oh no, that was the troll that hit him 2 away. She's just blowing him back there, I guess. And then that's it because there's no monsters on the board. So, Buernor's turn. He has 7 movement, and he has 5 normally, but if I make it 7, he could go 14, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. I think I'm going to do that. Hurry up, and he runs over here, and then let's hope this plan works. So, spawn roll. Yes, so failed spawn. She activates. She's within 1 of him, so she's going to fire blast him. Ooh. 2 damage and move him 1. Blasted over here, I guess. And then. What? There's no monsters? So it's back to Wolfgar. Oh boy. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, let's double move him over here, I guess. Because that's all he can really do. Because if he gets hit, he dies. So she's going to activate, or spawn roll. It's a 2. Oh no. No. Spider swarm. Ah. And let's see, she activates a counter card. Mark of the Wolf, I have to negate it or else they all die. So let's negate. And then Spider Swarm is within one tile of a hero. So it just poisons both of them like normal. Great. So I think that's the end of the game, because it's going to be Buernor's turn, and when he starts, he takes a damage, and that kills him. So,
another failure.
Alright, this is another attempt of mine of this adventure. The fissures are here, there, up there, and one's down there. I have closed them all off, and now it is pretty much going to be do or die, because what's-her-name has 4 hit points, or she has 5 hit points remaining, and Wolfgar has 4 left, and Buernor has 1 left. So it's pretty much just a battle between them. The only problem with it is that there are 2 traps that are guarding her. So that is where things are taking a bad turn for me. So let's see, who was it? Wolfgar just attacked her, so now, or his turn's done, so now it's Buernor's turn. Let's see, if I use the flask, it would do 1 damage, which is not good because I need to kill her. He could sacrifice himself to try to do more damage, which might actually be the best thing for him to do in this case. I think that's what it's going to have to come down to, because she's going to try to attack Wolfgar, which will knock him out of the way, and that just kind of extends everything. So, okay, he's going to do a suicide mission. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then he's going to use Notched Axe. 7 and 7 is 14, which is enough to hit her. So what that does is 1 damage. And then Power Strike will add another damage, so she has 6 damage on her. And then at the end of his turn, he's going to use his ability Headbutt to give her the death, or his death blow. He takes damage, she takes a damage, but that kills him. So that was it for him, since he's dead. And I have no healing surges, by the way, so this is pretty much it. What's going to happen next is I roll for monster spawn, but there's no places for monsters to spawn. Then she is going to use her attack, Blast of Fire. She got a 9 and an 8, so 17, which will do 2 damage and move the hero in any direction. So I'll move him over here. I guess I could even put him there, whatever. I think he has enough speed to get to her. So, what he's going to do is, let's see, 2, 4, 6, 7. She only has 2 life left. His ability will make either of his attacks do 2 damage. So he's going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and swing with Aegis Fang, which gets a +4 bonus if the attack is adjacent to the monster. So it's a +9. 9 and 5 is 14. So that does the damage, and then it does an extra damage because of his ability. So that kills her, and that is the end of this quest. This one has been annoying, because I feel like I close it off really quick, and then I just get overrun. And in this one, the last one was 2 feral trolls. This one had the feral troll and the arachnid lady and the drow wizard, actually. So that's what kills me, is getting those high HP monsters there. And I don't think there's anything. It just says victory. The heroes win the adventure when they have closed all 4 fissures and have defeated Vanel. So she's dead. Unfortunately, Buernor died in the process of doing that, but we have won. So let me know if I did anything wrong in previous videos. This is all going to be one video, so you'll probably see mistakes earlier in my first plays of this. Like, subscribe, check out other videos, and I will get the next video up as soon as I can.